Before trying to solve an optimization problem, we will first analyze its properties and its geometry. And in this week, we will focus on the objective function. We will do the constraints next week. The first property that is interesting for an optimization problem is called convexity. And this is what we will see in this video. The intuition of the concept of convexity is that a function is convex. So here is an example of function which happens to be convex. If you can take any points x and y, so that if you draw a line between these two points here, so with this point which is x f of x and y f of y, if you take a line, the line is always above the function. So let's make it more rigorous. You need to take any z between x and y. So basically it means that z can be written as a linear combination of x and y, where the coefficients of this linear combination sum up to 1 and are between 0 and 1. This actually linear combination is usually called a convex combination. You can see that if the value of lambda is equal to 0, z would be equal to y. And if the value of lambda is equal to 1, z will be equal to x. And for any value of lambda strictly between 0 and 1, z will be strictly between x and y. The definition of convexity says that this point must be above this point. So what is the above point? The above point has coordinate z for the x coordinate. And for the y coordinate, well, it is a linear combination between the altitude f of x and the altitude f of y. So actually, we can write it as lambda f of x plus 1 minus lambda f of y. So this is this point. And what is this point? This point is at coordinate z, f of z. So saying that this point must be above this point is the same as saying that f of z is less or equal to lambda f of x plus 1 minus lambda times f of y. And this should be true for any x and y, and any value of lambda between 0 and 1. So this is the geometric interpretation of convexity. Now you can define in a similar way concavity. Concavity is exactly the same, but in the opposite direction. So a function will be said to be concave if for each x and y, the line that you obtain by drawing between x f of x and y f of y will be below the function. This will be called concavity. And it's important to mention that concavity is not non-convexity. So a function can be non-convex, but also non-concave. Let's see an example. This function here, which is represented here, is neither convex nor concave. Indeed, let's take these two points x and y. If we draw the line between x f of x and y f of y, well, this line is not always above the function, so the function is not convex in this case, in this part of the graph. And if we want to check the definition of concavity, in this case the line should be always below the function. Well, it's not the case in this part of the graph, so this function is not concave either. Convexity is an important concept in optimization. In particular, when the function is convex, it is possible to find a global optimum. Actually, a local optimum becomes a global optimum. Therefore, it's actually advised to write your optimization problem using a convex function if you can do it, because in this case, you will be able to find a global optimum.